Vivacious. Vivacious. Vivacious? Let's just go with the North American way to pronounce this word, vivacious. How to be a vivacious woman. That is what we're going to learn today. Hello, lovely feminine women, and welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for being here, for supporting the femininity revolution, liking the videos that you enjoy, and of course, leaving me comments. If you are new to the channel, please consider joining the femininity revolution by hitting the red subscribe button down below, because in this community, we really are a sisterhood where we support each other in growing in our femininity as well as our homemaking skills. I am a big proponent on everybody coming together to support one another to really grow this type of movement here on the internet. I am a millennial housewife, and you can follow me on my Instagram as well as my other social media handles to find out what I do on a day-to-day basis. And if you're also interested in a little bit more about my background, you can go to the About section of my YouTube channel, where you'll probably find my experience as a former Miss Canada. But I want you to know that my life experiences are truly not paramount in comparison to anybody else's. It is just to provide you with a context about why I talk about the things that I talk about and where my information comes from. Putting that aside, let's get to today's video, where we are going to talk about how you can become a more vivacious woman. When you think about the term vivacious, I want you to kind of picture the woman that comes to your mind. I think somebody along the line of a bubbly personality, somebody who is carefree, somebody who is able to seek adventure on a whim. I am somebody who is quite prone to anxiety, and if you relate to me on any level, you might know that it is actually quite difficult to be a vivacious woman. However, I do think that embracing vivaciousness can help you be more feminine overall, because it will help you tap into feminine flow, a state of being where you aren't exactly concerned with all of those anxious problems that come in your mind. This doesn't mean that we will be immune to hardships in life. This is just going to help you become a more resilient woman, and it's going to help you live your life to the fullest. So both you and I are on this journey to become more vivacious, and I'm going to share with you today some of the things that I have done to become that kind of woman. I would love it if you would leave me a comment down below letting me know what you are working on, what are the qualities you think a vivacious woman embodies, and perhaps some of the things that have been successful in your journey to becoming a more vivacious feminine woman. Vivaciousness is one of the ways that we can also spread joy to the world through our femininity. That is a big element that I noticed when I was doing pageants. The women who caught the attention of the judges weren't necessarily the prettiest women. They were the most able to characterize vivaciousness in their own unique way. Your version of vivaciousness might not be the same as mine, because we have different personalities. It's totally okay if they are, because that's another thing that I like to celebrate on this channel, our differences as well as our similarities. But keep in mind that we're not exactly striving to be like a particular vivacious person. We are just seeking inspiration as well as the best version of ourselves that we are trying to be. The first quality that I think all vivacious women possess is an ability to understand beauty in an authentic way. Being a feminine woman, of course, means nurturing your body as well as your appearance, but I do believe that a vivacious woman is kind of ready for an adventure at any time. This means that you want to kind of adopt a lower maintenance beauty routine. This does not mean throw your looks out the window. That's not what I'm talking about at all. What I'm trying to communicate to you is an ability to streamline your beauty routine so that it actually aligns with your life. Sometimes when we see a vivacious woman who is all dolled up, we kind of associate the appearance with her personality and the energy she is conveying. But you have to understand that those are two different things. When I lived in Montreal, what I noticed was that women were mostly all put together. You would go to the grocery store and they were dressed similar to the way that people dress in Europe. They would have clothing that would be their lazy clothing, but by our standards would be dressed up. You can still hold yourself to a higher beauty standard and a higher put together look without spending hours and hours every single day on it.
I have to make a little bit of an edit here because I don't want you to mistake what I'm saying for meaning that I don't want you to look put together every day. I want you to look classy, elegant, put together, sophisticated. What I am saying is to kind of look for techniques that will minimize the amount of time that you actually spend on getting yourself ready. For example, understanding your signature style, having a streamlined makeup routine, being effective with your time, not overburdening yourself with unrealistic expectations, and the list goes on and on. The goal here is to have your beauty really be a part of who you are. This is why I advocate for the house dress oftentimes for homemakers, because it really helps you feel put together, but it still is comfortable, practical, and is something that you're going to reach for on an everyday basis. And it really takes minimal effort to look put together because your total outfit is just one dress. Same thing with the video that I did for feminine college students, where I advocated for finding a few hairstyles that are your go-to hairstyles, because you can keep these in rotation and you can get them to a point where you have mastered them and you can incorporate them more frequently rather than defaulting to a lazy hairstyle, for example. It all really comes back to consistency, because the vivacious woman is able to embrace life to the fullest, and in order for you to do so, you have to have a degree of balance and consistency in your life. So I talked a little bit about being ready for an adventure and doing things on a whim, and that is my next point that I want to discuss. Try to be an adventurous woman. Now, if you are a little bit scared of things that typically come to your mind when you think about adventure, I want you to rethink that a little bit. Everybody has a different comfort zone. I want you to think about your comfort zone and what you can do to push yourself a little bit out of that comfort zone. What are some trips that you can take, or just adventures around your neighborhood? What are some sporting activities or outdoor activities that you can do that are really going to help you push that limit and perhaps feel a little bit of an adrenaline rush? Maybe take some time and write yourself a bucket list. What are your goals in life? The things you want to do before you die. I really encourage you to actually take a few days and reflect on this and write it down if you actually have to. You can do everything right in your life. My mom did everything right in her life. She was extremely healthy. She was happy. She had a thriving career and she was an excellent homemaker, but she still wasn't immune to getting sick. You don't know what the future is going to hold and the types of stresses that are going to come in your life. You still want to live for today and you don't want to miss out on experiences. Being a vivacious woman means that you have a degree of ability to truly seize the day. The next thing that I want to touch on is cultivating true happiness. Not happiness through gimmicks. You've heard me talk about this on my channel before. But true happiness, what does it mean to feel everlasting joy? This could include immersing yourself in your faith, in the Word of God. But from a more secular perspective, I actually read a pretty good book the other day. I'm not gonna say the title because it had a bad word in it. But this book helped reframe the way in which I was thinking about the struggles and the hard emotions that I feel on a daily basis. It basically outlined that many of us are too preoccupied by finding that thing, that trauma, that life experience that caused for us to, for example, have low self-esteem or to feel jealousy or to lash out very easily. And it shed light on the fact that understanding the core event or the series of events that led to that particular emotion or experience might not be possible. And we might spend so much time looking for that thing that we aren't able to actually control our response. Instead of looking for the magic bullet, analyze your actions in whatever it is that you're struggling with. What are small goals that you can do, that you can congratulate yourself on, that will help you actually better yourself? For example, if you are somebody who compares yourself to other women every time you open your Instagram feed, it might be more worthwhile to focus on the actions and the responses that you feel and how you can manage those things.
Perhaps come up with a mantra that you're going to tell yourself when you feel those negative feelings bubbling up. Or set yourself a time limit, or perhaps completely disengage from those triggering pictures. This could also include cultivating healthy habits like telling yourself that you are beautiful or incorporating more actually achievable health goals. These things are going to help you feel more optimistic because you're going to feel like you have a sense of self-control in your life. And the vivacious woman does feel like she walks a little bit in purpose. She's not able to fret about those big, heavy emotions every single day because she is more focused on the things that she can control. You can't feel true happiness if you are continuously focusing on the negative. A last point in this topic, this subcategory, is to learn to stop and appreciate the little things in your life. If I am too focused on the big picture of the negativities in my life, I wouldn't be able to take this moment right now to observe my cat sleeping peacefully over there and feel gratitude for the fact that I have a cat, a healthy cat, and he brings me so much joy. Likewise, you are sitting down, consuming this content, you're part of a community of women who care for each other, you have the luxury of actually having a computer or a phone to watch this. You have the freedom to do so, and you have the time to do so. Those are all wonderful things that can help you feel happier. A very important point that I want to elaborate on includes the topic of play. Just because you're not a child anymore doesn't mean that you should not play. Creativity is one of the ways that you can tap into feminine flow, and it's one of the ways that it's going to be easier for me to explain to you feminine flow. When you are immersed in an activity, for example, a board game or a sewing activity or whatever hobby that you like to do, you develop a focus that helps you feel more relaxed. And this is closely related to the feeling of feminine flow. Your ability to just be, your ability to have fun again and to live in the moment. The vivacious feminine woman understands that she needs to make time to play every single day. Maybe it's just 10 minutes you play a little game on your phone. Whatever it is for you, you need to incorporate play. You need to schedule it. Also, take the opportunity to imagine the world sort of like you did when you were a child. An example of this would be going on a walk and picturing your favorite story as if you were the main character, or looking at the birds and thinking about a nice song or the way in which their life is. Like, what is it like to be a bird? I know it sounds very weird when I'm saying that right now, but those are all things that children think about that it might benefit you to actually think about them as well. It might help you feel that spark of childhood again. The vivacious feminine woman is also welcoming. She is ready for a party or a celebration. She lives life as though it is a celebration. And that includes a degree of being welcoming. You can do this as a homemaker by practicing hospitality, but you can also do this as a feminine woman by cultivating the character traits that go along with being welcoming. For example, if you watched my video on how to be charming as a feminine woman, I talked a lot about warmth. So I'm going to link that video down below as well as above, because I highly recommend that you check it out. You can also learn to give a genuine compliment. This is something that is going to help you exude vivaciousness because you're going to be able to see the most positive elements in somebody else. Not many people are going to get excited by the lovely color of so-and-so's dress, but you being able to notice that by actually using your tone of voice and your vocabulary to describe how nice that dress is going to exude vivaciousness. It all comes back to feeling wonder and appreciation for the little things. I do want to give you a little word of caution because it is something that I noticed working in a retirement home where you actually had to be quite vivacious to create a positive experience for other people. And that deals with terms of endearment. Cracking a little bit of a joke with somebody, a little like corny joke, is absolutely something that could be vivacious. But on that same note, you want to be careful of terms of endearment. What I mean by that is certain people aren't going to appreciate if you call them sweetie. And just be a little bit aware of that. But including positive connotations and choosing your words carefully are things that you can incorporate in your interactions with other people that are going to help you appear more vivacious. So those are the short points that I have for you today. Like always, leave me a comment down below. Let me know your additions to this list or your personal experience or whatever you want to leave that is a positive comment. And I look forward to our next video, lovely feminine women. I'm sending you so much love. And I'm hoping so many blessings will come to you this week. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.